Hi guys, good day, it's me, Teacher MJ. Our topic for today class is all about solving for simple interest. So without further ado, let's do this topic. Now to solve for simple interest class, our formula, that would be I equals PRT. I stands for the interest. P, that would be the principal amount. R, the rate of interest. T is time in terms of years. And we also have the formula for MV. Now, MV stands for maturity value. So, MV equals the principal plus the interest. Now, the question there, class, what if you are looking for the principal? How will you formulate the formula? So, once again, I equals PRT. Simple interest is equal to the principal times the rate times the time. Now, what if you are looking for the principal? How will you formulate the formula? Now, to get the principal, class, simply divide both sides by RT. Divide by RT. So, we can cancel this out. Alright, and the formula for P, to get the principal, that would be I over RT. Simple as that, class. To get the principal, this will be our formula. Now, what if you are looking for rate? Okay, if you're looking for R, for rate. So, once again, the simple interest formula, I equals P RT. So, to find rate, simply divide both sides by PT. Okay, simply divide both sides by PT. Alright, P, and then divide by T, so that we can cancel this out. Okay, divide by P and T. Once again, once you divide PT on the right side, you also do that on the left side, plus to make the equation balance. Once again, question, sir, why do we need to divide both sides by PT? So that thus the remaining equation on the right side of this equal sign will be only R, if you're looking for R. Once again, divide both sides by P and T. So cancel this out. Cancel this out so that the remaining equation will be only R. So therefore, our R is equal to I over PT. Now, what if you are looking for the time? So once again, simple interest formula, I equals PRT. So to get the value of time, you divide both sides by PR so that the remaining equation plus will be only the time. Alright, so divide both sides by PR. Okay. Divide both sides by PR. Divide by PR. Alright, and then we cancel this out. Alright, and then the formula for time equals I over PR. Now, without doing the formula transformation class, we know what will be the formula for P, R, and T by just looking at this magic triangle. Once again, class, we call this one magic triangle because without doing the formula transformation, we know what will be the formula in getting P, in getting I, in getting R, in getting T. So, once again, the formula of simple interest, I equals P times R times T. If you're looking for P, if you're looking for principal, just look at this magic triangle, class. You're looking for the principal. So that would be I. Okay, I is the numerator. Divide RT. So check, class. Yep, that's correct. Principal, I. So once again, principal equals I over RT. Same, class. Okay, same equation. If you're looking for R, I over PT. Looking for R. So I is the numerator. Then denominator is PT. So R equals I over PT. If you're looking for T, looking for time, so our equation will be I over PR. So I, once again, I is the numerator, and then PR will be the denominator. So just look at this triangle, class, this magic triangle. I'm sure, class, without doing the formula transformation, we can have the equation. Looking for P, R, T, and the interest. Alright, so if you understand this one, class, the formula transformation, let's solve example number one. Alright, so let's proceed now to example number one. How much interest is earned on 6,500 pesos at 4% for 1 year? Once again, class, first thing that you need to do is you need to understand the problem. Now, once you understand the problem, class, you write down the given. Alright, so we have given... So, we have given principal, that is 6,500 pesos. So, P is equal to 6,500 pesos. Alright, and we have given rate, 4%. So, once again, rate is equal to 4%. Our R is 4%. Now we need to convert that one class into decimal. Now what is 4% class in decimal? So once again, 4% to convert that one into decimal, just simply move the decimal point right to left twice. 1, then 2. So this will be 0.04. Or you can just simply divide this one 4, divide 100, and you will get 0.04. Alright, or 0.04. Alright, and our time class, what would be our time class? That's correct, our time is 1 year, therefore our time is 1. 1 year. Alright, and we're told to find the interest, the simple interest. So once again, the formula, I equals P RT. So simply substitute class the value of P. So our P is 6,500. So 6,500 pesos times 0.04 for our rate, that is 0.04 times our time is 1. And then simply use your calculator class, you will get the answer. Alright, so this will be 65 times 0.04 times 1, and you will get 260. So that would be 260 pesos. That's it, class. That's the answer, class, for example number 1. So let's have more example, class. We will have 5 examples, class, for you to really understand this one. Let's try example number 2, class. Alright, so let's work on example number 2. At what rate was an investment made that obtains 2,592 pesos on 10,800 pesos over 4 years? So once again, first step, class, you need to understand the problem. Now once you understand the problem, class, you write down the given. So our given, we have our interest. So investment made obtains. So this will be our interest. So interest is equal to 2,592 pesos. And we also have our principal amount. So principal amount is equal to 10,800 pesos. And we have given time, that is 4 years. So our time is 4. So 4 years, you can write 4 years, that's okay. Alright, and then we are told to find the rate. So use the formula to get the rate. So once again, rate is equal to I over PT. So rate is equal to I over principal times the time. Alright, so substitute plus the value. So our interest is 2,592 divide. Our principal is 10,000. So that would be 10,800 times our time is 4. So times 4. Alright, so once again, you multiply this one first. Do not divide plus, you multiply this one first. Okay, so this will be, let me just copy this one. This is 2,592 divide. We multiply this one, class. Use your calculator. Alright, so this will be 10,800 times 4. So this will be 43,200. Alright, and then you divide this one, class, and that would be the rate. So divide this one. So this will be 2,592 divide 43,200. And the answer, class, is 0.06. And this is not yet our final answer, class, because we need to get the rate. Therefore, we need to convert this one into percent. So to convert this one into percent, just simply move the decimal point left to right twice. 1, then 2. Therefore, the answer, class, is equal to 6%. That's it, class. Therefore, the answer is 6%. So once again, you can just simply multiply this one, class, 0.06 times 100 to change percent to decimal, simply multiply by 100. Times 100 and you will get 6. So that would be 6%. That's it, class. That's the answer for number 2. R is equals to 6%. Let's have another example, class. Example number 3. Alright, so let's proceed now to example number 3. Now for number 3, class, this will be quite tricky. So we need to be careful, class, in solving number 3. So what was the interest rate if your balance on an investment of 28,750 pesos at the end of 6 years is 42,550 pesos? So once again, class, first step, you need to understand the problem. So you have the investment of 28,750 pesos, and at the end of 6 years, it becomes 42,550 pesos. So after you understand the problem, you write down the given. Now, question, this 28,750 pesos, is this the principal or the interest? Now, always remember this one, class, the definition of principal is the amount of money that you invested or borrowed. So therefore, you invest 28,750 pesos. Therefore, this one, class, is the principal. Once again, class, be careful with that one, class. Principal is the amount of money invested or borrowed. And this is your investment of 28,750 pesos. Therefore, this is the principal. Okay, 28,000 is the principal. So 28,750 pesos. Now, what is this 42,550 pesos? Now, this 42,550 pesos, this is the total amount. And this is what we call class maturity value. So, maturity value, the total amount is 42,550 pesos. I hope you get this one, class. 28,000 is the amount of money that you invest. An investment of 28,000. So, therefore, this is the principal. And the total amount at the end of 6 years, it becomes 42,550. Therefore, this is the maturity value. Because the maturity value, that is the principal plus the interest, the total amount, that is the maturity value. And that is 42,550. And we have given time. Time is 6 years. So, therefore, this is 6. Or we can put 6 years. Alright, and then we can use the formula. We are told to find the interest rate. So, we are told to find R. So, our formula, there would be R equals, so R equals the interest divided by PT. Okay, P times the principal. So, do we have the interest? Nope, we don't have the interest. Okay, we don't have the interest, class. So, we need to find the interest. By using this formula, class, we can find the interest. Okay, once again, by using this formula, we can find the interest. So, MV equals P plus I. Once again, we do have the value of MB. That is 42,550 pesos equals our principal is 28,750 pesos plus interest. Once again, we are told to find the interest for us to solve the rate. So, to get the value of I, you can do the properties of equality. You have two options, class. First option, you can apply the properties of equality, subtraction property of equality. You can subtract both sides by 28,750. Subtract both sides by 28,750 so that you can cancel this out. Okay, you can cancel this out. And then subtract this one. Do not forget peso sign. So 42,550 minus 28,750, and you will get the answer, class. Simple as that, class. Subtraction property of equality. 42,550 minus 28,750. And the interest, class, I is equal to, so we don't have enough space, class. So this will be 13,800 pesos. Do not forget pesos equals the interest. So, simple as that, class. But once again, class, most of the students, class, they are so confused with this properties of equality. Subtraction property of equality, addition, multiplication, and division properties of equality. They are so confused with this one, class. So, to find I, class, you have another solution. To find I, we can just simply transpose 28,750 from right to left. We transpose this one from right to left so that the remaining equation, class, will be only I. Okay, transpose this one from right to left. Once you transfer from this equal sign, you change the sign. So this will be 42,550 minus, we transpose this one. Sir, why do we need to transpose? So that less the remaining equation on the right side of this equal sign is only I. So once we transfer, we change the sign. This will be 28,000, negative 28,750 pesos equals I. And then subtract this one, class, you will get the same answer. Let's do that. 42,550 minus 28,750. So we will get same answer, class, 13,800. All right, equals I. pesos. Do not forget pesos. So therefore, our interest, so the interest, I will just write it here, class. We don't have enough space. Interest is equal to 13,800 pesos. Alright, so once we get the interest, we can now apply this formula. So I hope you understand that one, class. You find the interest using this formula. Okay, maturity value formula. So our interest, we have the interest 13,800. So 13,800 over our principal is 28,750. So principal, that's 28,750 pesos times the time is 6 times 6. So we can cancel peso sign. Alright, and then you multiply this one. Let me just copy. Copy first, 13,800. Then you multiply this one, class. 28,750 times 6. So this will be 172,500. And then you divide this one, class. So once again, you multiply this one. And then you divide the interest and the product of P and T. So that would be 172,500. So 13,800 divide 172,500. Okay, it's division. 13,800 divide 172,500. And you will get less 0.08. And once again, since we're looking for the rate, we change this one into percent. To change this one into percent, move the decimal point left to right twice. One, then two. So this will be, so one, then two. So this will be 8%. That's it, class. That's the answer for number three. So quite complicated for number three, but we need to do it, class, step by step. That's the answer, class, for number three. Let's have two last example, class. Example number four. Alright, so let's proceed now to example number 4. If a loan is taken out for 6,900 pesos at 9% interest and costs 7,605 pesos, how long was the loan for? So we are looking for the time. So it says how long, therefore you're looking for the time. So once again, you write down the given. So we have given our principal, that's 16,900 pesos. So principal is equal to 16,900 pesos. Alright, and we have given interest. So this is the interest. That is 7,605 pesos. So interest is equal to 7,605 pesos. Alright, and we have given rate. That's 9%. So rate is equal to 9%. Once again, 9%. Convert that one into decimal. Simply move the decimal point right to left twice. 1, then 2. So this will be 0.09 or 0.09. All right, and to get the time, our formula, that is equals to I over PR. So time is equal to I over PR. So our interest, we have given interest 7,605. So interest 7,000. So 7,605 pesos over our principal is 16,900, so 16,900 times our rate is 0.09, so 9%, that is 0.09. Alright, so we can cancel peso sign because this is division. So you multiply this one first. So this will be user calculator, class. So simply copy this one, class. Copy 7,605, divide, so you multiply this one. Alright, so this is 16,900 times 0.09 and the answer is 1521. So 1521 and then simply divide this and that would be our answer. 7605 divide 1521 and the answer, class, is 5. So the answer is 5. Now once again, our time, class, in terms of years. So therefore, this is 5 years. The answer, class, is 5 years. That's it, class. That's the answer for number 4. Easy, right? For number 4. Alright, so let's try last example, class. What if we are looking for maturity value? Last example, class. Example number 5. Alright, so last example class, example number 5. If you borrow 65,000 pesos for 2.5 years at an interest rate of 8.5%, what is the maturity value of the loan? So once again class, first step, you need to understand the problem. And then once you understand the problem, you write down the given. So once again, the amount of money that you invested or borrow, this is what we call the principal. So this is our principal. And we have the time, 2.5 years. 2.5 years, so that would be 2.5 years. And we have rate, that is 8.5%. Alright, so given. So we have the principal. So P is equal to the amount of money you borrow or invested. That's what we call plus the principal. So our principal is 65,000 pesos. And our time, so we have given 2.5 years. So 2.5, we can write that 1 or 2.5. That's the same plus. 2.5 is just the same with 2.5. 1/2, it means 0.5. Alright, and the rate, we have 8.5%. So how will you convert this one plus in decimal? So 8.5, once again, simply move the decimal point right to left twice. 1, then 2. Alright, so this will be 0 or 0.085. Or we can just simply use the calculator, divide by 108.5. 8.5 divide 100, and that will be 0.085. Let's double check. Divide 100, that's correct, 0.085. To change percent to decimal, you divide by 100. Alright, and we are told to find the maturity value. So once again, the formula for maturity value is equal to the principal plus the interest. So we don't have the interest class, so check us. The formula of maturity value, principal plus the interest. We have the principal, but we don't have the interest. So therefore, we need to find first the interest for us to find the maturity value. Alright, so the interest equals PRT. So P times R times T. Alright, and then simply multiply class. Our principal is 65,000 pesos times the rate. So that is 0.085. And then times the time, that's 2.5. Simply multiply class using your calculator to get the interest. So this will be 65,000 times 0.085. Once again, class, be careful, class, in writing the decimals. 35,000 times 0.085 times 2.5. Alright, and the answer, class, this will be, so the interest, so let me just write it here, interest equals 13,812.5. Do not forget peso sign, class. Alright, so this will be 13,812 pesos and 50 cents. So this is not yet our final answer class, because we are told to find the maturity value. So to get the maturity value, so maturity value is equal to the principal plus the interest. All right so our principal, that is 65,000 pesos, plus the interest, that is 13,812.5. So add this up. So 13,812.5 plus 65,000 pesos. And the maturity value class. So all in all, the sum is equal to 78,812.5. So that would be 78,812 pesos and 50 cents. That's it. That's all set. Okay? All set for example number 5. So once again, class, if you have some questions, class, with regards to simple interest, go ahead, class. Feel free to leave a comment in the comment section down below. You can always message me, class, in our Facebook channel, same name with our YouTube channel. So I hope you learned something new today, class. If you like this video, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. You share it to your friends and to your classmates so that we can help more students. Once again, this is Teacher MJ. Have a great day, class. Goodbye for now. Bye-bye.